See, that's what I was thinking. You could have your Man of Steel floating over, like, at the moment until you get... Because that's what I had mine at one stage. I had to have mine. And I had the two cabinets. I didn't have enough room. And I had to put my Man of Steel sort of floating. What? I don't know, man. I like this. It's the shield I like in that one. Because what's the colour of the shield in his new one? Kind of green or something? Kind of greeny white? Do you see the one that once coming out for the Avengers Age of Ultron? See now how like he's not got a hole, he's not got a grip. It's supposed to be a magnet that attaches to the back of his arm. Oh, yeah. So when the shield goes on, you've got that original way, the way he just kind of doesn't hold it by a strap. He just has it attached to his arm and just goes. So that's what the new one's.
Did you not see when he froze it? When he froze it,
he's
got a thing that pulls it back.
I know. So you just need to get that. I don't know, the Avengers 4 is good, man, but you need to get the 4 from the Dark World to go with that Loki. Because it's kind of off, man. It's kind of off. There's something not right about that. Because I know that 4 is good, and it is good, but it's Avengers 4. It's not the one for Dark World. They were good to get Loki because Jim doesn't have Loki anymore. And the Loki in Forbidden Planet's about £200. So you're moving all them down then?
Going to move Superman and that down. They'll be doing it in the next shelf and then Robocop will go in the middle. Right up there underneath them.
Oh man, it's just, I wish you had your two caps, man. I really wish you had the two of them displayed.
I'll get them and then that'll be me. I've got another glass cabinet
and put it in there,
that'll be
me.
Glass cabinet
will
sit lovely.
Where are you going to put them?
Put them in
the
glass cabinet
just there again. You could well get another glass cabinet. Go for the black one this thing.
Yeah.
That's that. You can see my black one, see what you think. I like the black
one. You got that colour and the black?
I've got two of them and then one black. Yeah. That colour's good because it goes with your floor. I just wish you had your door fixed on it, but that's the same side to that one.
Catwoman, and you kind of went,
ah,
that's awesome, cats coming in.
Aye, but the way that they dealt with it in Rises was the fact that they said that she was a cat burglar.
Oh, yeah, I know.
So that's how she became Catwoman.
But then the whole, just a wee kind of faceplate there on her eyes, and it's not believable. I'm not that ready. It's kind
of. They tried to, that's what Christopher Nolan's ones is. It's no like comic booky world, it's more a realistic world, like
fans,
a city and all that.
Fans want a comic book.
Oh, I know, that's why I'm looking forward to Batman v Superman. See that world, man, that world looks so dark, and that Gotham City and all that, where you see like the Riddler sign sort of spray painted on the wall.
Suicide
wow.
Squad, but that's what I'm looking for.
Oh, I just see the whole, you know who's the Joker?
Yeah, Batman.
I know.
Yeah.
I know, man.
Yeah.
The whole movie looks so.
One of my favourite actors, man, I'm so glad, man.
I know.
Because look at him, you forget, and Fight Club, man, you forget. He's a blonde haired guy. And look what he's in, and he's like, you're wearing a
raincoat?
Yes, it is!
I know,
it's like, brilliant.
Oh, Seven. You released this. Yes. Hey, Paul!
Hey, Paul!
No, man. Can't believe that.
You know, that's what I remember Christian Bale for. I don't go Batman, Christian Bale. I go American Psycho, Christian Bale. That's what he's known
Definitely,
for.
Definitely, man.
That's what he's known for.
Definitely in my books, man.
Aye, me too, mate. American Psycho's one of the best films of its time, man.
It is?
Spectacular movie, man.
I don't think him as Batman, really. I mean, it is a Batman, but I'd be surprised if, like, Ben Affleck puts him...
Ben Affleck's just going to shit all over
him. I'm surprised I'd be really surprised if Ben Affleck puts him down a peg or two.
He will, mate.
Right down, man.
He's looking all that, he's big suit and all that.
His bulkiness, man. The amount of weight, like the amount of muscle he's put on for that.
Tell me, do you believe?
I know, none of that pure.
You will.
These people show full of people. Yeah. Red believe in good.
Red believe in good.
You know what I mean?
Frog.
See, I just like that. Tell me, do you bleed? When Superman falls down, it's like, you will. That just looks so amazing, man.
I think he looks a good Bruce Wayne as well.
Oh, yeah?
See, the look in me goes, that's how it starts.
I
think he looks really good as Bruce
It does,
Wayne.
Doesn't he?
He's,
looks...
he's kind of got a Michael Keaton kind of the way his hair and all that's kind of...
he looks traumatised. He looks like
he's
something trouble on him. And yet everybody's slagging him off. Everybody's like, before
don't
that trailer, was
get
like...
Me wrong. Oh, don't get me wrong, to begin with, when I heard, I was kind of slagging, but now I was like, I need to stop, I need to wait and see how he looks. Then as soon as I saw how he looked, I went, he actually might tick every box for me here tonight. I just go, tick, tick, tick.
Plus, I like the Batmobile. I like that.
See,
I like
but
that
then, fair enough, but Jim's kind of skeptical about it. But
Jim doesn't like it, man, but I like the Batmobile.
I think it looks alright.
I like the Batwing, the way the Batwing goes.
I wonder who's going to be the villain, but because it's Batman v Superman, but I wonder who's the villain.
I think it's going to be Lex Luthor.
Do you think it'll just be him? Just
I think he's set it up. I think
he's. Do you think it'll be any wee end bit that you see?
Well, the next one's supposed to be leading on to Suicide Squad.
You'll see a wee bit of that at the end of this film?
I don't know, man. That's more of a Marvel kind of thing, innit? Really? Mm-hmm. And do you know the thing about Marvel is Marvel's mere. I like the way the DC's going with this, like, Man of Steel was more a darky world.
I know.
And then and all the Marvel movies are all dead kind of light and comedy. I like that difference. Because it's the same with Man of Steel. If Man of Steel was more like, I don't know, like Captain America or something like that, I'd have went, oh, it's too, it's a wee bit of comedian jokes and all that in it, sort of the way that Marvel were doing, that's copycatting. But I like the way DC's just taking their own way, going like that. Fuck that.
The first Captain America was dead dark.
Aye, dead dark, but still jokey, still had wee jokes and stuff like that.
Yeah,
innit?
I know, but
that was the way Marvel goes, and then they have their wee bit at the end, which shows you like what's next. You know what I mean? I don't need that from DC. I'd like DC to do their own thing. I like DC going dark and.
Winter Soldier was just spectacular. Even everybody says that was one of the best films.
Because that's what I want with this Batman v Superman. This is more of a Batman story. I want Batman. I want dark, gritty, comic booky world.
In fact,
we're getting Suicide Squad, that we know Suicide Squad's coming.
I went to see it on Saturday.
What?
The Age of Ultron.
Did you go see it?
It was good, I got to admit it was good, but I still prefer the...
Where did you go?
I went to just Clybank now.
Did you get a popcorn?
I got a wee small one, I don't have that from whatever money, so I just got a small.
Where did you go with?
I went with Dad and then my mate Reed, and that we went, and they all like it and all that and stuff. I still prefer the other one, but... I
see what I'm saying? Like the robots baddies, it's alright, but a robot baddies not as good as they're always quite tiny.
They're
always put down dead easy.
I don't get it why bringing Magneto's two children into it. That's Magneto's children.
The only person I really felt hold that for them was the fact that I liked what's his name, Paul Thingy's character. Jarvis is when he becomes the what's he call it? So when Jarvis puts his memory into the...
Jarvis, and then he becomes the...
See the guy that plays him? He's played Jarvis all these years.
All these years, I know.
That's the voice of...
He's the voice of Jarvis.
That was him that married Jennifer Connelly years ago.
That
was his name. In fact, does he know In a Beautiful Mind? Does that know him In a Beautiful Mind?
I think he is, actually. I think he is In a Beautiful Mind, aye.
Aye, because that's him. It's him that plays the... What do you call him?
Remember they say his name?
Aye, remember he floats and all that? And he picks up Thor's hammer?
That
was cool. In fact, do you know what I liked about the end of that film though? It was so weird, like, I think that's Hulk going away. Hulk's not going to be in the Avengers. I think that's Hulk leaving the Avengers team and going drifting off.
No, because they're meant to be doing that, because they're meant to be scrapping these two Hulk movies and doing that.
I know, but what happened at the end of that movie was basically Avengers, the new Avengers team. And Hulk's not going to be a part of that.
Well, you know who's going to be the new part of the Avengers, don't you?
Spider-Man?
Mm-hmm.
I know, but that's what annoyed me about that. I was hoping for the wee spotlight, the wee cameo bit at the end was going to be a Spider-Man's thing. That annoyed me. It was just Thanos. We've seen Thanos. Obviously in Guardians of the Galaxy. And I don't need to see him. I wanted to see...
There's nothing at the end of the Age of Ultron right at the end, but
nothing. That's what annoyed me about that film, was nothing at the end, because I stood the first time and it was nothing. I was like, fuck. And then went next the second time, and Andrew says to me, there's not, don't bother staying right to the end. There's something at the end, but there's nothing at the very end, which is a shite, because I don't know what's happening with Marvel now. But I was hoping them that next, and then all they tell me next, do you hear what they're doing? What's the Civil War and Captain America? Do you hear what they're going to be doing? Iron Man. Yeah, Ant Man's going to be in Captain America.
I'm just coming up there now. Are you in the shop? What? Yes, I'm here. John. I'm just coming up there now. Are you in the shop? Right, we'll just wait, get me at the door then. Just give me the money at the door. Right, okay, I'm heading the new. Right, I'll see you in a couple of minutes. No, it's just Paul came in and we're just kind of chatting and that, so. No, because I was sitting in and Paul came, so we're just blathering. Right, I'm coming to new. Right,
brother. What'd you hear? Who here is going to be in Captain America? Yeah. Ant-Man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And actually, I'll show you when you come back, but I watched that movie talk thing. They've even got the whole list of everybody that's going to be in it. And to me, it's more an Avengers film than it is Captain America. There's so many people in it. There's just so many characters. I'm like, whoa, it's basically half the percent of the Avengers that are in that film. I'm like, what's this going to be about? Because, like, why are they flinging Ant-Man in it? Because Ant-Man's obviously getting his own film, but he doesn't need to be in Captain America.
Remember, it's a Civil War, so it's going to be a big thing, you know? It's going to be a big battle
anyway. Yeah, I know, but it's... Then it's leading on to Infinity War.
Mm-hmm.
Infinity War's going to be Avengers.
It's Guardians of the Galaxy 2, that's what I can't wait for.
Oh, aye, I know. I know, but it just annoyed me that. But the fact is that Hulk is not going to be part of Civil War. Hulk's left Avengers, Hulk's sailed away. That was that, and then that's what annoyed me at the very end of the film. It's like Avengers, and it's like ready to say assemble, and then it's like that's the new Avengers team all sitting there. I'm like that. So that's Hulk away. Hulk's just cheery bye byes. Do you know what I mean? Like, you've just basically wrote him out. And do you see that way they were setting up Hawkeye's death in the film? You thought Hawkeye was going to die, and then it was like, that's them saying that Hawkeye basically is another member that's going to leave, because they're saying on the movie talk thing that people at the companies up in Hollywood and all that are saying, like, we're going to take a couple of the old characters out and give you the new characters. So Hawkeye's basically, plus he's sitting down with a baby and all that. Now that's them trying to tell you for that whole film, Hawkeye won't make not mean.
You've got to remember that happens in comic books. Comic books, you see characters dying and
then
you see.
I know. I just feel that I felt that Hulk should have got a much needed. I think Hulk should have been in at least for Civil Infinity War. I think Hulk should have been.
No, because you say
he
works
with
a team. He doesn't work
himself. I know. That's what I said about the films. The standalone films are crap, man. But.
Well, the last one wasn't crap. The last one was probably watchable, but it was just kind of like, ugh.
Yeah.
And then here they're going to do another one. They're going to scrap these two and do another one with him, the Richard, whatever his name is.
That may be interesting. Because
he's going to do it and all that, and he'll do it, and then they'll make it interesting. They'll do something. They'll know they'll make it with their last two.
Back in a few minutes. Right, man, I'll see you soon, mate.
confirmation as I got him. I thought, I need to get a Joker. And some teams in Aussie will work it. You hold that, you put his arm up.
That is a good pose, man.
That's what you call a perfect pose.
See,
I can always pose my things.
Just, I kind of get my jacket. Did you get the jacket on top of the jacket?
I get the jacket on top of the
jacket. I kind of get the jacket on top of the jacket. I had to take my jacket off at first and put that one on.
Excuse me. I'm a master at getting it on, mate. If you
but do you know, miss, do you know...
You want your jacket on, I'll get your jacket on. It is, trust me.
Who's your favourite one?
See, I don't know. I'm off here. Mate. I love the main joker. But yeah.
Yeah, I like the main joker because look at his mouth, it's closed for a change.
Yeah, I know, but.
Or copycat.
But still, I wish. Like, if you look at him, it's still the same costume as that. The only difference is it's in black and white. So. Not much difference. The hat's different, yeah, and his feather. Feathers don't really different, so getting up here, get the same costume.
Size different?
It's different. Ties, really the same, it's just different color.
And the trousers are different.
The ties, that's tartan, right? That's tartan, but it's like just black and white. So you're technically getting the same cap. Look at the, see that coat there? That coat there's the exact same as the inner coat.
Hmm.
The only thing you're not getting is a big jacket to go up. That's the only thing you're missing. You're getting everything. See that there? That's the same on that. You're getting that. You're getting that. You're getting this. You're getting that. You're getting the same type of gloves. You're getting the faces different. Fair enough, that's the best part about that. That bit there.
You bring the other one back out and you compare the two heads. Add hair in the back of the first ones. They fixed that. They fixed the problem with that.
Of course, the boy that hunted, didn't they? I mean, just make sure you're in that pose. Well, see, that's the only problem. It is good, but you can still see a wee bit of gap.
I know, that's why I keep the hat on.
Whereas you go look at that, you compare them.
Plus the hair's a bit different, I think it's more lighter green.
If you look at them, that one's more enclosed in compared to that one, you've got a good bit of gap.
They did fix it, but didn't they?
Aye. Which I think what they should have done is they should have pulled all of them back in and fixed it. They should have pulled all of them back in and fixed it, but they weren't going to do that, were they?
I love all three of them, but it's just that I'm really hoping that Comic Con this year gives us.
I mean,
we're getting returns, I understand that. We knew we were getting a returns line ages ago. But I just feel that we should have got something else. An art museum joker at least.
Remember you were watching that video with that wee guy, and he was thinking about the mind joker, and he was going on about mind joker, this is the DX, blah, blah, blah. And he goes, and then remember he was speaking. And he was going, well, do you know what would be a nice piece to kind of think, oh, what if they gave us something like the art museum joke, and you were like,
I'd be even happy if they brought a two-pack, the art museum joker, but they also gave you the other joker with the normal face, because sometimes he's got that, obviously, the other face.
No, but what about changeable head? Changeable head, having me no makeup on, then having me the splashing damage, go boom.
I know.
Having two changing heads.
I think that the main joker and leave it off is.
That's quite annoying, isn't it? Just a main joker.
I mean, I love it. They gave it.
And the fact is, he's in less the film than the art museum joker. Do you know that?
Yeah.
That museum joke is in more of the film than he is.
Yeah, but I still love the fact that he gave us it.
I know, but do you not see that? How long is he in the film for?
A couple of seconds.
How long is that museum in it for?
No, a good long bit.
A good long bit compared to that. And you go, you're bringing this out.
I don't know, man. I know that we're getting...
That museum joke, I swear, see the big... That would amaze me to be...
I just don't hope it's left at the top. This is a new line that we're going back to.
I know, and I've been testing
it. I think it's...
Finish the Batman 1989.
I know, man.
Finish it.
Do you know this Batman we're getting from the tongues is in a BX?
What?
That's in a BX.
What is it?
Just a normal version, but yeah, they're being with the BX stand, they're being with the iPod. I don't know what's happened to that. Because all of a sudden he was the last BX.
Aye,
I don't know why they've just left after that. There's nothing else came out of the decks.
He's out the road.
Oh, I know.
He's out the road. That's
him,
I've got him. I don't have the worry, I don't have the stress. I don't have to go,
oh,
I need him, I've got him.
I know, man. I know, because he was getting, he's going up in price. I mean, if he's...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When he comes in, that'll be 10 hot toys.
I know, just think. If you get next one...
12.
Oh, mate, you better not fly by me.
And then I might even go for 40, because I might even get that 40 and then go, I've got 4 hot toys in one day.
Man.
And I'll just shaft you in the ass.
See if you do get 4 hot toys in the one day.
And you just go,
Then you wouldn't even do that. You wouldn't even go for, like, you wouldn't even do 2 caps, you wouldn't even get the, say, what would be the Terminator, and you wouldn't even go for.
Would you win
a soldier?
Right, look at that's 2, that's 460, that's 460, that, and then that's 5, that's 610, that's £610. I mean, I could possibly do it. Wouldn't leave me a lot at the end, but I'd do it. Just
be well worth it, man, wouldn't it?
It depends.
Oh, man, I can't wait for you to get that cap, that 2-pack, man. I know, all you need to find is somehow you get a Star Spangled Man somewhere, or...
I just love this, his legs, because what I was hoping today is... Bring his legs, no, his legs doesn't really move.
His legs do move.
No, but did they move round?
Ah, you can bend them.
Yeah, like move, like round, like that.
There's tons of good art ways of...